What's up, racing fans, and welcome back to another edition of the Before the Odds podcast, yes. March 8th, 2023.
Big weekend coming up, baby.
Let's go. You know I'm already back. It's Pick 5 Johnny, but you know who I got with me now.
Big Willis in the house. I made it once a week. It's hard for me. He said it. Four daughters. They all play sports.
Yeah, that's real. That's real deal fatherhood right there, man. We just want to know one thing, Big Willis. Did you guys win that championship?
We did take home the championship. Two teams, second place in the gold bracket with the 10U team. Shout out Derek. And yes, we took it home.
Let's go, baby. That's what I like to hear. If you're going to miss some good horse racing, do it for some championships.
And we all the girls were watching horse racing in the dugout in between innings.
There we go. That's what I like to hear. That's what it's
that's
about.
That's real. That's real.
That's what it's about. Reaching kids from five and people to 90 years old. All right. We got the Tampa Derby this weekend.
Biggest day at Tampa.
Tampa Derby. And then for a special pick, Big Willis is going to take us out to
Gulfstream at the Hurricane Birdie, one of my favorite tracks and one of my favorite races, honestly.
We're going to Gulfstream, Oaklawn with Big Willis, and you'll be at Santa Anita with the West Coast Killers over there in Cali.
It's hard for me to bet. Over on the West Coast, one, a trainer out there I don't particularly care for, and a lot of people don't either. Just
we can't name names, though.
I won't
we can't
name names. He runs all the dirt races. It's kind of getting stupid over there, but the West Coast Killer could bring that down. I didn't look at anything on the West Coast, but I have a little bit of opinion just off of quick handicapping. But I'm excited for the Xuri. I'm excited for Secret O's, Clairiere. Interstate Daydream is a horse I liked last year.
Yeah, Interstate Daydream is nice.
That's a really good race, and I'm excited for the Oaklawn races too, for sure, but most excited for Tampa and Gulfstream.
Tampa, dog. Let's do it big. All right, let's go ahead and get into this card. We're going to start on race seven. We're not doing what we did last week. We're not going through all the races. That was a long one. All right, we're taking you guys through five races, 7, 8, 9, 10, and 11, ending with the Tampa Derby. Grade 2 Tampa Derby. So we're going to take you guys through those races, tell you our picks, and we're hopefully going to hit for a little money. We're going to hopefully hit, like you hit those championships like we speak. We're hopefully going to hit those championships like you did that last week, Big Willis.
Yeah, that'll be real nice. And you know what? Last week wasn't a total letdown. There were some nice picks in there. We just didn't connect with the doubles or connect in a pick five. But if you were listening and you play differently than horizontal racing and you play each race individually, you could have capitalized on some of the picks that we had.
True, true. A couple of trifectas, meaning you picked the top three horses in that race, finished 1, 2, 3, and maybe a couple of exactas.
If you don't know what that is, maybe you should check out the beginner's wagering or the beginner's show or the advanced show of wagering that Johnny holds Monday or Sunday mornings, right?
Yeah, we'll go ahead and we'll throw one out. We'll throw one out on Monday next week. We're going to throw a Monday. We'll go over handicapping one-on-one. We'll talk. We already talked about doubles, pick threes, pick fours, and pick fives. We'll break down those exactas, those trifectas, and the superfectas for you. Especially those are going to be very handy when it comes to the Kentucky Derby, because that's where the big money is. You hit that trifecta, you hit that superfecta in the Derby, that's where it's at.
And to be realistic, those races or those wagers are more fun for people just getting into it, because it's over in the race. You betting the race, yeah, individually is just more fun for beginners. If you're more advanced and you're more into horse racing, playing the pick fives, pick fours, pick threes, doubles, it's just more fun. You know a lot more of the horses, and it's just, you know, that's where the money's at. But beginners playing each race individually, don't look at it any other way. It's a fun way to play.
All right, let's get into this card, man. You know, I like this card a lot because there was three horses I bet on previously. All right, Juniper Moon, Tappet Trice, and Surprisingly. I'll have two of those three in my bets, but I'm not going to have Surprisingly this time, actually. So Surprisingly, I won't have Surprisingly.
That's wild. But here, so race seven.
Let's
right
go.
Right off the bat, man, one of the first horses I looked at, if you look at your PPs, is Worthington. Paco Lopez is winning at a crazy clip right now, 42%. It's got Money Mike Maker. I believe you gave him that name last time. I'll draw a line through that
race.
The only race on the dirt is the only race that was bad. And they threw that horse into that Sam F. Davis because, you know, everybody's got Kentucky Derby dreams. Could have been the owner's pick. I'm pretty sure it wasn't up to Mike Maker. He probably would have kept this horse on the turf. He's better on the turf anyways. And
Yeah, so that's the first horse I looked at when I looked at this race. Easily just drawing a line through it. Go to that Dania Beach down at Gulfstream. And that was a solid race. Finishing third, you know, came off the pace, rated, and closed into something. And there was nothing there for that horse. But that was first off the layoff. Now we're coming, like you said, second off the layoff. Back on the turf, Mike Maker. He's been running. Paco Lopez aboard. I like it a lot. Talk of the Nation is another horse I like. Sammy Camacho, 25%. Suge McGahey. Sammy's pretty good over at Tampa. He beat us a couple years back when we were over there. And him and Daniel Santana, we just for some reason, were with the big-name jockeys, and those guys ran us out the park. 1x4 last time out. First time on the turf. And Quality Road, those horses could go either way. Suge McGahey, he knows how to get a horse ready. He's hitting at an insane clip. Second with the power rating. Just another horse to like. And the last horse that I took was Lights of Broadway. Mm-hmm. You have Mark Cassie, $250,000 horse. And I got something pointed out here. Besides drawing the line through the last race, Never Threat, 7th, 11th, just way out of its league. This is the type of race this horse needs to be in. No grade stakes, you know, for this horse. Second off the layoff, but here's the one. First time gelded, first time LASIK.
Is that first time gelded?
Yeah.
I thought the G was bigger on first time gelded. Now, I'm not, we might have to cut that out. Because when did he get gelded? Between December and February?
Yeah.
Really?
Yeah.
Okay. Absolutely. All right.
Yeah, first time gelded.
So should we edit that out? No, I'm just like asking you straight up.
Edit out after when I said it.
To all right, go. Say, go first time.
So, yeah, I mean.
Say first time gelded.
I'll start over on Lights of Broadway.
All right, go.
And the third horse that I take is Lights of Broadway. You know, you have Mark Cassie, $250,000 horse out of City of Light. City of Light was one of the horses you really liked. You remember that?
Mm-hmm.
City of Light actually won down at Gulfstream, I believe, was the Pegasus. But this is on the turf. It doesn't matter. Draw a line through that last race. 7th, beaten by 11th length, 17-1 odds. This horse doesn't need to be in greatest stakes races. Right back where need be. And, you know, the numbers say it. Take the races on synthetic. Take the race in the turf on Gulfstream. Second time off the layoff. First time gelded. First time LASIK. Stuff you like. If that's what we're going by, that's an easy horse to take. I don't have any strong opinion. I don't have a win wager. But my top pick is the 7, Worthington. And then I like the 10, Talk of Nation. And then I like Lights of Broadway, the 5. But I have to mention one other horse. Smoking Lightning. This horse, if you look at it quickly, and if you're horse racing 101, it's easy to like this horse. Won last time out by, I forget what it is that I wrote on it, but 6 furlongs. And then, you know, not bad 4th, 2nd. The only 2 wins for this horse is on synthetic. That doesn't always transfer over to the turf. And it's easy to get sucked in by that horse. But I got to mention that horse because I was a little bit drawn, but I'm going 5, 7, 10.
Okay, so you're just mentioning that horse. You're not taking
just mentioning the horse because I can see people liking that horse. And
okay,
smoking the only 2 wins aren't synthetic, and people love to say synthetic plays over to the turf. Gulfstream's definitely doesn't, and this horse I don't see doing much on the turf.
Okay. Yeah, I definitely like that Lights of Broadway. We all know I lost on that gelding. Not first time LASIK, but that gelding really hurt me bad. We all heard that on Sunday's recap. But I'm going to go ahead and take Freedom Trail in here. Freedom Trail, it's supposed to be posted as the 1, but the post positions aren't out yet. That's just the first one on the PPs.
Oh, so my numbers are probably off.
No, they won't be off. They usually have them in that order, but sometimes I might have 1 or 2 as an added entry.
All right, Freedom Trail, first time LASIK, IRAD.
Freedom Trail, yeah, I'm not really going with the IRAD. I'm going with the first 2 on the turf, 1, and then the last one, obviously, was line through because we had him running on the dirt, and he's better on the turf. And he lost to Instant Coffee, who's come back and went 2 races. So that's another reason I like that horse. Worthington, another one coming out of the – this is another one that's coming out of the that came on the dirt. And was doing well on the turf. Yeah, I'm fucked up here. Go back, rewind. All right. Yeah, then I'm taking Worthington as my second pick. I like Worthington coming out of the Sam F. Davis. Didn't really run well, but ran well when it was on turf. Is not on Lasix again. I kind of like that. I like when a horse hasn't run on Lasix at all. I like a horse coming in, not run on Lasix again. I like that angle too. Seems like I like all these angles, but I like this horse. I definitely like Money Mike Maker. I definitely like Paco Lopez at Tampa. So that horse will definitely be on my pick three or double ticket. And then I'm going Mostache. Coming out of the Breeders' Cup Juvenile, which was a grade one. A lot of good horses have come out of there, losing to some really good horses, and only by three lengths. Finished fourth, but only by three lengths. I like that a lot. Okay, the trainer not really known, but we got Luis Saez. I think Luis Saez might bounce back with this one after a terrible week at Gulfstream. So I'm going Freedom Trail. I'm going Money Mike Maker with Worthington. I'm going Mostache coming out of that big race in the juvenile turf, grade one. Coming back, getting Lasix for the first time, and carrying 2 pounds less than most of the field.
We got to be careful with the numbers. So if you're listening and I'm giving my numbers out, I'm sorry. We'll give names from here on out, because if the numbers aren't correct, the numbers aren't correct. Remember, before the odds, before the numbers, we got our PPs early. So
yes, sir.
Bear with us on that. Bear with us on that. So listen to the names we say, and we'll try to keep it at that. Race 8, Johnny, post time, 3:33. Got a mile and a 16th. You're looking at some four-year-olds and upwards, right?
A challenger.
And this is a great race. You want to know why? One of my favorite drinks is sponsoring this race.
Wow.
Michelob Ultra is one of my favorite beers to drink. Shout out Michelob. Say what you want. It's a light beer and it tastes good. Ready for a sponsor.
Wow. Okay. Shout out Michelob.
Shout out Michelob. So we went and watched this horse last year in Tampa, and I said it would be the Derby favorite. And I might have had a lot of Michelob Ultras, but it's funny. Classic Causeway is a great horse. 2 for 2 at Tampa. First time Lasix.
Yep. Isn't that Lasix?
That's an angle, right?
Tell him.
First time Lasix out of Giants Causeway. Kenneth McPeak, Julian Leparu. 2 for 2 at Tampa, horse for course. Horses that like Tampa tend to stay liking Tampa, and they come back, you know. They don't just run the way they run there at a track just because of luck. If they like it, they like it. And it's not the strongest field. I think this is a good race, a good starting point for Classic Causeway to come back this year and prove that he is really a solid horse.
And you know what I like about what you're talking about with Classic? Obviously, the first time Lasix off of a layoff specifically. Mm-hmm. And then check out that last March. I think it was March 3rd workout, and you got 5 furlongs, a minute bullet, and first out of 25 training that day. So I think this horse is ready to gun it like he did in the Tampa Derby and win it like he did in the Tampa Derby.
Yeah, man, I can see that. I totally, totally love that pick right there. And then the Reds. Mm-hmm. This horse is harder to find. You look at the last race, 10th. Lost by 19, 4th, 8th, lost by 40, close up, stop. But then that win right there, if you go back and watch that 62 op, Saratoga, strong track, coming out of the Kimmel Barn. I feel like they won those, you know, the two good races at a lower level. Then they just got their heads full. They went to a grade 3, then 100,000, grade 3. Now this grade 3, this challenger race right here, this race is closer to those optional claiming races than it is those grade threes.
Yeah, 100%.
It's just, you know, like, okay, Endorse, right? Lost to Endorse last time out. Octane, Dean Delivers, Farmington Road. These horses would be odds on in this race, all of them. Whether you like those horses or not, they would be odds on. So you could put a line through those races. Now you're back at the same level, even though it's not. I know those were 62 ops. But these horses in here aren't that good. I think honestly that's the best horse in the race. So, you know, that's
wow,
the
horse. You're going Reds, best horse in the race. I think so. I think Reds is gonna be like 15-20 to 1.
Yeah.
Easy. So I like that.
I like it too. It's good because it's dirtied up form. It's muddied up.
100%.
It's muddied up.
And you already know when Reds is on Lasix, he runs his best. Third, second, fourth,
you're right.
Second. Back first, on LASIK. Fourth by a quarter of a length. Back on LASIKs, I like that pick a lot. That's my long shot pick.
Safi in Florida is good.
For sure.
All right. Safi and then the last Joseph. Horse I took is a two, is Skippy Longstocking. Safi again. He's good in Florida. I rat aboard. You know, when I rat jumps on a horse, people, a lot of people aren't jockey guys. I'm a jockey guy. I don't care. I rat jumps on a horse, the horse chains. Look at the class of that horse. Oh, there's 100%. No way I can sit here, run a double, run a pick three, get beat by Skippy, who's not going to be the favorite.
Who do you think's getting it?
I think Classic.
Classic? Okay.
So Skippy's not going to be the favorite. I can't sit here and get beat by the horse that's coming out of grade ones and grade threes with the buyer speed figures and those just everything points towards this horse. That's not going to be the favorite. I like Skippy? Not that much, but I'm not getting beat.
Yeah, I'm hoping Tax will take a little money too. What's crazy is I don't even have to say my picks because you just set them for me. I got the same three, bro.
Any different reasoning?
No, man. I like the Reds a lot because he's getting LASIKs again. He runs his best on LASIKs. I like Classic Causeway a lot because you throw out those turf races except for the one where he actually won, which is kind of like a freak thing.
Yeah.
But then you look at his dirt form, it's pretty good. And he's getting LASIKs for the first time. So you know he's going to be ready. I like that bullet training. First set of 25 on the day. And, yeah, I love Skippy Longstocking because a lot of these horses coming out of the specific race, Pegasus, right, coming out of the Pegasus, mm-hmm. a lot of those horses are running really well. Stiletto Boy, who got third in that race, just won the big cap over in Santa Anita. So a lot of horses coming out of the race are doing well. Obviously, Art Collector, who won it, looked great. So, yeah, my picks are the same. I'd say, yeah, long shot, like I really want the Reds to win. I think Classic Causeway wins, but I definitely think Skippy's right there for second. Hopefully the Reds cleans it up for third. But I'm definitely going to have all three of them in my double and my pick three.
That's very rare that we sync up like that.
Oh, 100%. That was a sync up.
Let's go.
Let's do it, bro.
But you talked about the peg real quick, and I'm not going to get deep into it. As far as the Pegasus, I've been wanting to say this. A lot of it, and you're right in what you're saying, Stiletto Boy on the West Coast. A lot of people were hating on the peg this last one because there wasn't that Arrogate. There wasn't that big name. You know? But horses coming out of that race are all doing good. So this might have been the most competitive Pegasus that there's been in a long time. Because you have a 1-5 or a dominant horse come in and win, and that's it, right?
And arguably, I'd say that Art Collector winning the way he did and Charger losing the way that he did this last weekend, to me, Art Collector's got to be the favorite for the breeders.
Male horse of the year.
Breeders right now. Yeah, and obviously, this is a super, 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 super early prediction, but I definitely think Art Collector's like the head of it right now.
For sure. I ultimately, I think a 3-year-old is going to take it, which is crazy, but.
Oh, so we're going back to authentic.
And just in general, I just don't think the older males division is that strong.
No, I agree.
Especially with Charger losing the way he did. And I don't see, I know you got mad at me with your endorse pick. I don't see endorse winning two more races before the breeders. I just don't.
I don't know.
I mean, endorse looks like a changed horse. Not often do horses bounce back after.
That's dude, money.
It might have been 2 years without a win.
That's money Mike Maker, bro.
Mike Maker knows how to claim him and turn him around.
Mike Maker is doing some things down there, man.
I hope he's doing it the right way.
I think he is.
I hope he's doing it the right way. All right. It's hard to see.
I think so.
I agree.
I think you have to after what happened a couple years ago at the Derby.
Ooh, Medina?
With Maximum Spirit, Maximum Security. No, I said Maximum Spirit. I meant Medina Spirit. No, nobody. I'm talking about Maximum Security, the one that really got busted, Jason Service.
Yeah.
That one, that was a bad one. I think Mike Maker's good, man. I think he's doing it the right way, and I think he's training his horse as well. That horse was coming in one off LASIKs and then one again off LASIKs. I don't know. Sometimes these horses just wake up. They really do.
I hope it is, man.
100%.
Jamie Ness. I hope it's not Mike Maker.
That's Navarro, Money Mike, and the
Service route, but people are thinking it, so we're talking.
He's good.
Okay.
All right, and on to race 9.
Yes, baby.
This one right here, got to say the name, the Hillsboro. last year, I got to test Big Willis. I always got to test Big Willis. All right. I'm the teacher here. I got to test Big Willis. Big Willis, who won the Hillsboro last year? I'll give you a hint. His last name is Street.
His last name is Street?
Yeah, he's got a first name.
Bleeker.
Yeah, there you go. Bleeker Street.
Let's go.
Came on the scene like a freaking shot out of a cannon, bro. That was awesome.
Yeah, that was awesome. Bleeker was one of my favorite horses last year to watch, straight up.
Bleeker was a beast. Same trainer that Bleeker had is the same trainer that we like this horse for this race this year, which is crazy, but not, because this guy is the king of the turf. He is the king of the turf. You hear the word Chad Brown, he is the king of the turf. It don't matter where you are, he's the king of the turf.
Surprisingly.
Okay.
You're right.
Yeah.
Shantasara is my top pick. I ratted Chad. I get nervous when they go over to Tampa, man, because they haven't treated me well. Yes, we had Bleeker. Yes, Bleeker, bro. But overall, Chad has come over to Tampa and not really over the years. You know, he's sent some big names out there, man.
I wouldn't even say just over the year. Chad, over the years, I would just say, like, especially over this year, since I've watched Tampa, I haven't seen a lot of Chads, like, killing it. Right.
I know. That's what's scary.
For sure. That's why. That's
and
why.
Then you look at She Dares the Devil last weekend at Gulfstream, and she lays an egg.
She Dares?
Yeah. You know what I mean? Like, Chad lately is not Chad. Like, he sends out these big name horses.
Yeah, wait. Oh, you're talking about Speak of the Devil.
What did I say? She dares. Speak of the Devil.
Yeah.
But you know what I'm getting at? Like, Chad for sure. Is not Chad. Like,
yeah, well, you know what? I will say this. Speak of the Devil wasn't running well when Chad took her to the bench, and she still is inconsistent. And I'd say the same thing about the other horse in here, Rugier, who's the same thing. And I think Shantasar, and we talked about this last week when we were on the phone, when you're going between your 35 softball games, and I'm just here. But we talked on the phone, and we said Shantasara is up for a big race. And what's cool about this one is the race is going a mile and an eighth, and Shantasara is 2-0 at a mile and an eighth in her two races at a mile and an eighth.
Well, she's got nine on the board for out of 12, you know, first and second.
Right.
Shantasara stands out above these horses, even above Rugier, and Rugier's going to be the favorite, which is
crazy. I hope.
I think so. If I was going to take another horse, it wouldn't even be Rugier. It would honestly be that Brandon Walsh horse, man. Temple City Terror, coming off two wins. Another one of those horses, kind of like yours.
Right.
Right? 29 races, 7 first place.
Yeah.
2 of those 7 are the last 2 races.
No, Temple City's nice.
I like Temple City. I don't particularly like these horses, and I usually throw them out, but after Endorse beating me and you getting on my ass all week about it.
Correct.
It's hard to, like, not recognize that now. 2 last time out, good speed figures. The Brisnet speed figures are good. If I was going to use another horse, it would be Temple City Terror. That horse might beat me this weekend. But I'm going to single that Chad and I have.
Have to. Shantasara is.
Yeah, I'm gonna have a nice one bet.
I like Shantasara a lot. Hoping to get some good odds. Hoping to get 3-1, please, or maybe 2-1.
So, man. I think hopefully.
Like, well, I mean, Scottish Star is not bad. Surprisingly, won last time out, so you know people are gonna want to bet that horse.
At Tampa, right?
At Tampa.
So people that don't bet that go to the track are gonna remember that horse.
That's what I'm hoping for. I'm hoping they don't remember Shantasara's run in the filly and mare Pegasus when she was flying home at a mile and 16th, and now she's going to mile and 8th, which she's 2-0 at, and I think she's ready for a big, big run. Like, I'm really excited to watch her, and I think the Tampa turf, the way it's playing, I think we'll get a little pace here, and I think she'll come flying home like a bat out of hell and take this race.
Single for you, sir?
Single all the way. Has to be.
If you were to use another one, who would you use?
Oh, man. I honestly, like, I want to say Scottish Star.
I would use Bleeker Street.
Oh, yeah.
Her out for the second time.
Yeah, hopefully. I don't know if she's running in this one.
I think Bleeker.
I wish he was. Around. I hope we see Bleeker again.
That was such a nice hit that day.
That day. Well, and then we were at the track prior to watch her first off the layoff when she did win at like 9-1.
We go to Tampa a lot, just so you guys know. Tampa and Gulfstream are our tracks. We're Florida-based boys. We're up here in Orlando, Castleberry, Winter Springs. Tampa's the closest, but we love both tracks, man. If you've never been down to Tampa, go check it out, man. It's everything you want in a racetrack without all the glitz and glam.
Yeah, Tampa, especially for the turf. The Tampa turf.
Gorgeous.
And then Gulfstream. Yes, and then Gulfstream, I'd say, just for the glitz and glamour, 100%.
Gulfstream's a different.
They got the restaurants, they got the shopping, they got the casinos.
You know who else they got?
Who they got?
White and Barrio!
Yeah, we won't stop saying that around here. That is for sure. For sure.
What do we got next, my brother?
All right, we going on the turf again. And we got the Florida Oaks, three-year-olds. We got the three-year-olds running the Florida Oaks. And this is Phillies. We got the Phillies running the Florida Oaks. I am going to be at a horse guy here for sure. I'm going to live up to my name. And I'm taking 5 horses in this race. Because I have a single in the last race. I think we get a price home in this race.
What's funny is that, like, no lie, he says at a horse guy because I always say that. He used to always have a lot of horses. And I was like, all right, well, I'm going to be at a horse guy. I only have 4, and he still beats me. I got 4 in this race.
Yeah, I had 5.
It's a hard race, man. Like, the Philly races, the 3-year-old Philly races, they're tough, man. And this one is really hard. Ultimately, I ended up on Fascia Bella, right?
Yeah, Fascia Bella.
Fascia Bella, Dreaming of Snow, particularly from the man raising his hand in the background, Jesse, the producer.
Shout out, 37-1. Jesse.
He had him 37-1 at Tampa last time out. Like, how do we not use that horse again? And the horse did look impressive. Juniper Moon, another Tampa just glory day. So John over here is top pick on the same day. This was on the 6th, right?
This was on the 11th, February 11th. Sam F. Davis day.
We're at the Sam F. Davis, me, our producer Jess, John. John's top pick in a maiden race is Juniper Moon.
Last race of the day.
It was just an amazing hit. And then our producer Jesse just, he's all over Dreaming of Snow. And a couple of us, not me, a couple of us had a win bet on that horse. And it sent us home just feeling good, man. So, am I using them just because of that? No. They're logical in this race. If you look at Dreaming of Snow, yeah, this is a turf race. Well, why not give it a shot? If you get on the front end in Tampa and you're the lone speed, do I think the lone speed? No, but I think it's the fastest horse. I think Dreaming of Snow is going to be on the lead, coming off that dirt speed compared to turf speed. I think Dreaming of Snow can get the lead. Sammy Camacho knows the track. You got Gerald Bennett hitting at a crazy clip, 31%. Mm. He's up there with Chad and these guys right now. Why not ride the hot streak? First, fourth.
Is she going to get a fourth or is she going to get a first next?
She might get last. But I'm not getting beat by Dreaming of Snow, straight up.
I think the thing you can rely on, like, that kind of makes it not a good pick, but something that you can kind of ease your nervousness if you take that horse, is that the jockey's jumping back on Sammy Camacho.
Absolutely.
So obviously he knows he's on something special. I want to see her run on the turf. I want to see if this horse can be, no, I didn't use her, but I want to see what she's got on the turf. But I'm worried if they don't take it off the turf for too much rain, that she might scratch. But if she doesn't, I want to see what she's about. I think there is some good pace in here. So I do like a horse that can sit off and come with a run. But yeah, I want to see what she has. I mean, she impressed all of us that day.
It would be pretty cool if she won this race.
Yeah.
I mean, I know you don't have her, but it'd be pretty cool to see this horse race.
Yeah. The only problem I would say, and this is something to think about if you play the horses, whatever you're doing, is Dreaming of Snow won at 37-1 last time out. She will not be 37-1 this time out. So you have to ask yourself, am I willing? She's going to be 15 to 1. Maybe. She might be less. So, you know, it's like, do you want to take a 15 to 1, a 14 to 1, when you could have had her last time out at 37 to 1, like our producer Jesse did?
Jesse.
So, I don't know. But go ahead. So, you got those two, Juniper Moon and Dreaming of Snow.
Juniper Moon, man. That last race at Tampa was nice. On the lead. Tampa turf on the lead, man, pays off. It does. But I'll get into the other horses I like. Free Look. Chad Brown, Irad, $300,000 horse, first time like Lasix. Look.
Yep.
Coming
out of the Breeders' Cup Juvenile.
Coming out.
Another
and
one.
Layoffs, like you said in the show, you don't really worry about Chad Brown and layoffs.
No.
The only other jockey to ride this horse, Flavion Pratt. Mm. So you're getting the top two jockeys in the nation.
Yep.
You know.
I think Flavion's done on the west on the East Coast.
You think he's back over in the West?
I don't know. I mean, he's definitely back over on the West. I know that. But I haven't seen him definitely as much as last year when Chad was riding him. But, I mean, then again, maybe.
I'll tell you right now, man. A lot of these guys come over from the West Coast, and I think they can ride with these
right.
guys.
Yeah.
And they can't. They just can't build that rapport with the trainers. Like, so think beyond Irad, Joel, Jose.
Right.
Javi. Think beyond those guys. Johnny V. Think beyond those guys.
Yeah.
Think Manny Franco. Think Tyler Gaffleon.
Yep.
Those guys aren't so. Those guys don't get the big races or get the horse that I ride and Joel do.
Oh yeah.
And they still, to me, ride better on this side than.
Oh yeah.
Flavion Pratt.
For sure.
Or remember when who was really hot at one point? CD out at.
Oh, Andrea Van Dyke?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah. Or he's, like, gone now. I don't know
DVD.
What happened, man.
DVD. But you see how good he was doing on the West Coast and he fell off?
Yep.
Those guys from the West Coast, they kill it out there in Santa Anita. They kill it at Del Mar. They come over to the East Coast and they can't do
100%.
Nada. 100%. They try to go to the Midwest. You know, shout out to Rafael Bergeron because he's one of the ones that stuck it out. Because he left the West Coast, went Midwest, and he stayed there, and he struggled, and now he's one of the top dogs in Midwest. Shout out to Rafael Bergeron. He's one of my favorites.
Yeah, he's nice.
He's underrated, man.
He's
he
nice.
He doesn't get the mounts he should.
He kills it at Oaklawn.
So, Pasilla Bella, Dreaming of Snow. I got Juniper Moon and Free Look. My top pick would be Free Look Irad.
Oh, yeah.
Sorry it took so long on that, but this is a hard race.
Chad and Irad.
Go, Mr. Five Horse Guy.
Yeah, five horses, man. I definitely like Mission of Joy. I like Mission of Joy and Juniper Moon, actually, because of their two races back. So, actually, Juniper Moon got second two races back, but I like that race better than the one she just won when we were at Tampa. Three races back, because two races back, she was on the dirt, and she didn't fire anything, because she's not a dirt horse, she's a turf horse. And also, I'm liking Mission of Joy, because of that maiden win, two back. Looked real good. Grand motion on the turf.
I like last race back.
Sorry. I don't really like the last race back.
I do.
I definitely. You got to watch that maiden race, man. She was flying. Flying and extended by four lengths. Yeah. It was nice. And came back.
Faster time,
figure.
Too. Definitely. At the same track. Two for two at Tampa. I like that horse, too.
I like that horse. I like Alphabella, Steph's Charm, and Navy Goat. Because they are all coming out of the race with Cairo Consort. And I also like the fact that Alphabella is going to get first-time Lasix. I like that Navy Goat's going to get first-time Lasix. And I like that Steph Charm's going to get first-time Lasix. So I like all those three. Because of the race coming out of Cairo Consort, I think if Cairo Consort's in this race, 3-5. Easy. I think so.
Yeah.
After the race she just had, and she just went off in a similar race at like 2-5, 3-5.
Yeah, yeah.
So I think the same thing. Those horses coming out of that race, getting first time Lasix, I like that a lot. Luis Saez is staying on Alphabella. She'll probably go to the lead or try to. Navy Ghost getting Daniel Centeno, jockey for the courses, and Steph's Charm is getting Hector Jr. Diaz, and I like that jockey there.
You see, what scares me about Navy Goat not taking is the Daniel Santana. So you're 100%. Losing Joel, but like, if this was
Tampa. Oh, but Joel hasn't been riding that good, actually.
It's Joel. Joel or Santana, come on. But at Tampa, I don't think that's big of a deal.
Nope.
Santana's eaten us up.
Yeah, before.
And you know what? When we just went down to the Sam F. Davis, a lot of my picks, people might say this is weak handicapping. Playing a jockey. I don't care what you say. When you go to a track on a big day, and I don't care if it's Charlestown, Tampa, when it was Calder, I don't care what track it is. When you enter a track, and Irad and Joel and Gaffneon and Flavion.
Right. I get what you're about to say.
The guy that runs the track still wants to show up and show these guys you're at his track.
Oh, 100%.
And this is Santana's track.
100%.
Sammy Camacho, Daniel Santana run this
track. Even Paco Lopez.
Paco runs Florida.
Any of those guys that when they're not the Irads, when they're not the Jose's, when they're not the Florent Drews, like how good would it feel to beat those guys? Just like when you're an underdog in sports, right? Exactly. So if I win with Daniel Centeno on a 21, I'll be pretty happy about that.
I'll be upset.
All right. Race 11. The big, the bad, the grade 3 Tampa Derby.
Let's go. Classic Causeway.
Let's go. Here's what I'm going to say. I'm going to give Wills some props here because I'm always giving him shit. All right, Wills. Last year, I know you don't bet them because you're not pick five Johnny. But last year, if you would have played the pick five for 50 cents and all your picks, you would have won $750, sir. Right. And I want to give you your props now. You had some great picks that day, and I think you're going to have some great picks this day. So just shout out to Big Willis. Got to show him some love sometimes because I give him a lot of shit throughout every day.
I killed it that card.
Killed it.
I killed it that killed card. It. I'm just not a pick five guy. I play it when we go. I do play it when we go to the track. We were there. It's just, I don't know.
But here's the thing. I respect that. As a horse player, you have what you play, and you play it well. Period.
Yep. It hurts when I see that, though. It hurts when I see a nice pick five payout, and I didn't play it. But
yeah,
you're right. 100%. I did have it, man. I appreciate the shout out.
100%. Because I was definitely salty that day because I didn't play those plays and I didn't win the pick five.
And it sucks if you played the pick five. And Classic Causeway was one of my top picks.
100%. I don't even know if you had anything else but Classic Causeway.
I don't think I did, man. It makes me happy that horse is racing this weekend on the same day. It
100%.
Does.
100%. Just like Whitebarrio last week.
I'm telling you, man, Classic Causeway is going to bring home.
That'd be cool. I said
it's going to be cool with Classic
Causeway. I'd like to see Classic Causeway bring that home.
I think that's cool when the horse goes back to the track the day of. Like when you see a horse go back on Derby Day and you know what I mean? Maybe they 100%. Fell off a little bit or whatever it is. Whatever big race they won, they go back to the track on that day. They tend to do good, man. If not, I'm always pulling for them. This race to me is not that it's easy. Tappet Trice is just ahead of these horses. $1.3 million. Luis Saez. Todd Pletcher. I think Todd's got something special.
Oh, yeah, man. He's got four Todd. I mean, he did win the Belmont. Actually, he had the exact on the Belmont last year.
I'm just talking this year right now, man. Like, Todd's got Forte. Tappet Trice is supposed to be better than Forte.
Yeah, that's what they were saying.
Horses were bought and bred. Tappet Trice was supposed to be better.
That's what they were saying.
We don't know yet, man. And I think this horse is way less proven. It's not even close.
100%.
We'll see. Not a lot of horses come out of the Tampa Derby to do great things.
Nope.
Todd doesn't send his best horse here to do great things. Granted, he has. I don't think you need to look far. I think if you're looking too much and you stare at the PPs, you could end up on his other horse, Shisterkin. I think that's a horse you end up on. Out of Violence, 330,000. You know, are you going to take a horse that lost by 8 lengths or won by 8 lengths? To his stablemate. Shisterkin was a favorite in that race.
Yep. I remember because I bet on Tappet Trice, actually.
With laces.
Right. Now, I know it's crazy, but now let's take it back. With Lasix, without Lasix, we're always throwing that around. I definitely throw that around a lot. So my whole thing with Shesterkin is, without Lasix, he broke his maiden. Then he put him on Lasix, which I didn't understand why, if he broke his maiden without it. So I think Shesterkin, honestly, will run better in this race without Lasix like he did his maiden race. Right? So that now that's just my thought on that specific horse with that specific drug.
Why he didn't is because two-year-olds can't run with Lasix.
Oh, okay. Okay, there you go. So there you go. I just got schooled.
Two-year-olds at Gulfstream can't run with Lasix.
Okay. At Gulfstream specifically or anywhere?
In general. Two-year-olds can't okay. run on Lasix. So he obviously wanted this horse on Lasix. Now he could, as a three-year-old. Now they're going into a graded race where you can't.
Well, there's some.
I think this horse will eventually run on Lasix every time.
I don't think so.
What?
I think this horse is going to run. I think he's going to run better off Lasix.
So Tappet Trice has a win on Lasix by 8. Freaking smoke in the field. And without it, by a neck.
Against
coming off the pace.
Now against Slip Mahoney, who was okay.
You're
in
right.
The Gotham.
No horse in here is better or worse than Slip Mahoney. Like, I look at classic legacy, Billmott, Irad. Irad never rides for Billmott. He's jumping on this horse because that's the classiest horse outside of all the other ones. Mark Cassie has classic car wash, 105,000. You got Lord Miles, Paco Lopez, Joseph Safi, lost by 11 last time out. Just none of these horses, they're all coming out of that Sam F. Davis, long odds. None of them look like they have the future of Tappet Trice. Why Tappet Trice is not Triple Crown nominated blows my mind. So that's the only scary thing. None of these horses are Triple Crown nominated. And they just, it doesn't look like the strongest Tampa Derby that we've seen. I think Tappet Trice blows these horses out of the water. It's not even, he won by 8, he's going to win by 8.
Wow.
Seriously.
See, I went 3 deep. I think Shesterkin's going to run a better race than he did. And I think that early running speed is going to help him. I do like Tappet Trice. I just haven't seen a lot of horses come from that far off. So we'll see. We'll see how far Tappet Trice gets shuffled back, if he does get shuffled back. And then, yeah, I like Groveland, man. Groveland, and that's your boy, Daniel Centeno. I like Groveland.
I mean, that's one of the biggest reasons. So
that wasn't why I took him. I took him because he reminds me of Dorth Vader, who won at 47-1 at Gulfstream. Now, I could say that, and mind you, get very humbled next week when this horse, Groveland, comes in at dead last. Bless you, sir.
Thank you.
But, bless you. But I don't know. I think this horse can run big again. And if Tappet Trice isn't on his A game, I mean, any one of these three-year-olds can win it, honestly. Like, I'm not, but I trust me, like, before, maybe a week or two ago, I'd say Tappet Trice, easy money. But I don't know. This week, I think Shesterkin off the Lasix. I think Groveland running a good race last time in the Sam F. Davis against Litigate in the Sam F. Davis.
Yeah.
Who won.
You're right. And got second in the Sam F. Davis.
Got second by a length.
I think Daniel Centeno had a big part of that.
Daniel Centeno.
See, I don't think that horse even sniff Tappet Trice. But when you got Centeno.
Now, when you look at the top three speed last race, who is it? It's Groveland.
I know.
It's Shesterkin and it's Tappet Trice.
You got Centeno. You got a Godolphin.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? They pay money.
Godolphin. I didn't even look at that was a Godolphin, bro. That's
sense. If I was going to take another horse, it'd be Groveland.
Correct.
I just think Tappet Trice is a different. Like one of those. I think Tappet Trice and Forte are going to be up there with Arabian Night.
That's it. if you're talking about right now.
But honest, like top horses, yeah.
Those three. We'll see. I mean, we're going to see.
Good crop. I think it's a good crop. I really do.
I don't. I'm not going to judge it yet. I can't.
I am.
I can't.
I think it's one of the better crops that we've had.
We also had Classic Causeway as a Derby favorite last year.
Also had Good Magic. Hey, listen, we all have our good picks. Oh, no.
I'm not saying it was a bad or good pick. I'm just saying, like, that's why I'm not going to say, because I've said
it's
it before.
Early. It's early.
Big Willis last year said Classic Causeway was going to be the Derby favorite. He was 40-1 on the Derby day. I said the year before that Greatest Honor was the most powerful horse I've seen. He was the only horse in, well, he was one of three horses that only won the Holy Bull and the Fountain of Youth back to back in the last 30 years.
Yeah.
Right. And I said that was the most powerful horse I've seen. He didn't even run in the Derby. So we all, that's why I'm saying, I'm not saying anything yet. I probably won't say anything until the day of the Derby when the gates open, honestly, bro.
I'm a little more aggressive with it.
I am.
I'm a little more aggressive with it. I really, really like Tappet Trice. I like, hear me out, Blazing Sevens. I know people are going to be like, wow, you're crazy. Not for the Derby. When okay. Blazing Seven stops the Derby trail and starts doing one-turn races, that horse is going to make some noise. But I don't want to get off topic. Let's go ahead.
We can't. We got to close this thing down.
Close it up.
All right. So that's race 11.
Are we going to do this last one?
We're not doing the last one. I wasn't doing it. I wasn't planning on doing it.
I'll do it if you want.
Big Willis didn't get the memo. We ain't doing the Maiden in the Mile
Who wants
Turf.
It? Who wants
the
it? They want if it. You people want, want it. Right,
you
people
can get,
want it.
You can get Big Willis's pick in race 12. Just
it's a Maiden 32.
Well, wait. So we're going this. Big Willis, race 11. He's got Tappet Trice singled. Your boy, Pick 5 Johnny's got Groveland. He's got Tappet Trice, and he's got Shisterk, and those are my three. Not in that order. My order's probably going to be Tappet Trice, Groveland, then Shisterkin.
All right.
This guy's got Tappet Trice. Race 12, give us your picks, Big Willis.
It's going to be quick.
I don't know who's in. All right, let's do it.
I'm not a Maiden guy.
Correct.
You've known me to skip Maiden races.
Yes, and Maidens, for all you new subscribers.
Handicapping 101.
That don't. Yeah, I didn't go over Maidens, unfortunately, but it's easy.
Quickly.
It's horses that haven't won a race. That's it. Simple.
Easy.
So when it's a Maiden race, every horse in that race has never won a race.
Strapped up.
Ever.
Got the steel belt on.
That's it.
That's the Maiden. All right, so in your horse racing 101, please also next week describe what a Schwami play is.
100%.
Because this is all I got.
I got it. And anybody who has any other ideas or has any other questions about words we're throwing out there, subscribe, like, and go ahead and leave a comment for us so you can figure out what we're saying so we can explain it.
Swami play.
I will throw that out there.
My toughest bad to the bone daughter. Choke you out, pin you down.
Oh, that's easy. They're good. All the other three aren't gonna like me. It's Paigey.
Scoop! Double scoop. Little Paige, 7 years old. She's a track star and a wrestler. It's a Swami play, strictly. I had to give it out for my daughter, man. Double scoop, I saw it.
Wow.
Andy Dutro, Julian LaPeru, you got a good combo, man. It doesn't look bad. First time out. Nothing crazy here, guys. I mean, you got Clement in there. You got Thomas Albertroni. You got Dutro with two in there. It's a good Maiden race, 32 on the turf. You know, it's strictly a Swami play. I did it for my daughter.
Swami.
A double scoop. If Scoop was here, you're telling me you wouldn't bet on her?
Nah, Scoop's my,
if you
Scoop's
guys
my
knew
road
Scoop,
dog.
If you guys knew Scoop, you would
Scoop's
bet on this.
Scoop's my road dog.
She's bad to the bone.
100%. All right, so that's it for the Tampa Derby card. Now, we're going to give you kind of like our special picks.
Yes, sir. You go first.
I'm going to go ahead and go first. I used to be known as the West Coast Killer. Now I'm the West Coast Cold Killer because I've gotten real cold over there. But I got two races that I'm throwing out there. It's nothing as in-depth that we usually give, but I'm just giving you names for the races. We got the San Carlos, the 7-furlong race on the dirt, and I'm going Get Her Number. Get Her Number's run some good races in the past, and I think this horse is going to come just off the pace, run them down, mow them down. Get Her Number in the San Carlos. And then race 8, the Beholder Mile. This is a good one. This is a race with some really good class in it. I like them a lot. And we're going to go ahead and throw Pauline's Pearl with none other than yours finest, Steve Asmussen, the most winningest trainer in America.
I knew you were going to take that horse.
Had to have Pauline's Pearl.
I like Pauline.
100%.
And you love Pauline's Pearl.
100%.
All right, go ahead.
Even though she dukied on me last year.
She'll duke you on you from time to time, but Pauline's nice. She's still racing, and I like that.
I just can't get the fillies right, and maybe that's a personal problem.
Damn, called himself out.
I guess I'm just throwing myself under the bus tonight.
Jesse, you got to make that. You got to put that on his profile. Put that on his dating app. Can't get the fillies right.
We got Pauline's Pearl. We got Midnight Memories, and we got Desert Dawn as our three picks. For the Beholder Mile and the San Carlos, we're going get her number. Big Willis, what you got for us?
One, get her number. Phillies, can't do right. Perfect for Johnny on the West Coast. Two, shout out to Beholder. If you didn't watch that horse run.
Which nobody on this podcast doesn't even know California Chrome, by the way. I hope they do, but
they might. Beholder was one of the best mares to run out on the West Coast.
What's a mare? Let them know.
The mare is she's ready for breeding, man.
Okay.
She's ready for breeding. She's not a filly anymore. Mm-hmm. So you have Beholder. She was absolute beast. She beat all the ladies. They put her in the male races, and she dominated there too. They named a race after her, the Beholder Mile. I used to love West Coast racing, and my ROI there just is not good. I don't like the big guy out there with the silver hair. I don't like West Coast racing. But it is what it is. So me, personally, I love my track, Gulfstream, my home base. I got the Hurricane Birdie. There's two stakes races out there. You got the Captiva and you got the Hurricane Birdie. I decided to go with the Hurricane Birdie. When you first look at it, just like everybody else, Frank's Rocket.
Got to,
right? But that horse will let you down.
100%.
That horse will dominate and then let you down. Happens all the time.
Mm-hmm.
I'm still Frank's Rocket.
Gotta be. I love that horse.
Jafaros.
Beat us at Tampa. That was a big effort, though.
But you know who it didn't beat? Me. I had the double.
That's right.
We didn't use it in the... We had a combined pick five, didn't use Jafaos, and lost combined pick
four.
And was it a pick four?
No, we had a combined pick five.
We had a combined pick five.
But then we had a pick four at the end.
And Jafaos, I totally... because of the pick five, I was so let down that I forgot I had the double, and I hit that nice double. Paid like $32 to $36, and I had it five times. Like, that was a huge hit for me. Jafaos is going to get to the lead. It's so scary because Frank's Rocket, when she doesn't get her way, she tends to lay an egg. And now you're at Gulfstream where speed plays favoring. Jafaos could do this. Frank's Rocket is my top pick.
Gotta be.
I'm using them both. Yeah, and I'm running a double. I'm running a double into the next race only because of Jafaos. And the double I'm running into it is the Todd Pletcher horse with Sammy Camacho, man. The More Than Ready horse. I'm going to play a small double. Wow. I'm going to have...
Wow, you heard it first here, before the odds. Small double, Big Willis.
Small Jafaros, double, just because I think...
Frank's Rocket with...
I think Javar with more the More Than Ready Eddie.
More Than Ready Eddie.
Yeah, shout out to Eddie Edo. Shout out to Edo. Shop Edo, bro.
Subscribe, Edo. I'm going to say that. You better subscribe.
Shout out to
100%.
Him, and I could have used more horses in this race, but I'm not trying to invest down there at Gulfstream this weekend. Be smart with your money and your investment.
Correct.
I wanted to use Jafaos in some kind of fashion, some kind of form. I don't play exactas.
You're not going to play the ice cream.
I don't like that stuff. So I'm going to use them both into a double. Single in the next race. Not a lot. I'm talking $2-3.
Mm-hmm.
Just for the action. Frank Rocket's going to win. And I'll have a small little wager on Jafaros.
Let's go.
And then if I'm going to talk quickly about the other stakes race there.
Let's go. Oaklawn Park. We're staying at Gulfstream.
I don't like Sonny Leone riding there. Mamba Wamba, watch out. The Brian Lynch. Mamba Wamba, the Brian Lynch Irish entry.
I love
and then
Mama
the
Mama.
Last race is over at Oaklawn Park, the Azeri. This Oaklawn, race is Azeri
always has some good fillies in it.
Honestly, if you're going to talk about top-notch race of the weekend.
Got to.
This might be the best one.
Let's go.
All right. You have Secret Oath, the Oaks winner. multiple stakes winner.
Yes, sir.
Went up against the boys.
Yes.
All right, and did her own Clairiere.
Clairiere, love Cup, that. Love should have won the Breeders' Cup. Go ahead.
Probably went up against Malathot. You know what I mean? Then you got Interstate Daydream. That was one of my top picks last year as a 3-year-old.
Black Eyed Susan.
Then you got the up and comers. Moon Swag and Hidden Connection. Those horses aren't bad. Are they in that class level? No. If you're not on Secret Oath, Clairiere, or Interstate Daydream, I think you're nuts.
What was the other one? There was another one in there. The
Moon Swag.
The one that goes to the lead, I thought.
Moon Swag.
No, there's another one.
Hot and Salty?
No.
Okay. Oh, Vita?
No, keep going.
Lovely Ride. No.
That horse goes to the lead. It's not bad.
Yeah, no.
You're going.
If you're not on Secret Oath, Clairiere, or Interstate Daydream, you're nuts. And I don't think you could take all three.
No, you won't pay. You can't.
I think you got a single one of them. Ooh. This was such a hard race for me. My Oaks pick last year was Secret Oath.
100%.
I said it from Beast. January.
Secret Mama Tranca. Right? Correct.
All right. I also loved Interstate Daydream.
Yeah, 100%.
You got Dale Romans at Oaklawn, Tyler Gaffneyon at Oaklawn, Clairiere, Steve Asmussen at Oaklawn. Joel didn't go to any of the other parks with more racing, more stakes racing. He went to Oaklawn. This was the toughest race for me of the weekend. I'm giving you one pick in Interstate Daydream.
Interstate Daydream. Probably going to be third on the choices.
Out of them. That's 100%. One of the... And I'm not an odd guy.
I'd say Clairiere is like 9-5. I say Secret Oath, maybe 2-1 or 8-5.
Interstate Daydream, Secret Oath.
Interstate Daydream is going to be... Clairiere's so Interstate Daydream, on the back. Secret Oath, Clairiere's on the back. You've always been more of a Secret Oath anyways.
You know what's crazy is I used to like Clairiere too.
In her 3-year-old season, and then you wouldn't believe me about Malathot. And then Malathot's search results went 1-2 in the Oaks.
You're right. And there was, who did, go ahead and talk. I'm going to talk about who Clairiere used to go up against. That I was,
no,
Travel Column. 100%. I didn't even see it. I liked Travel Column, Clairiere.
100%. Those were your two favorites.
And they took longer to, Clairiere took longer.
A little longer. Malathot was the beast.
Though. Yeah.
Malathot, if she comes back, if she comes back.
Even though Clairiere beat her.
Yes.
And then Malathot beat
him. Yeah. Malathot won the ones that counted, especially the Breeders' Cup. So
Interstate.
All right. So you got the Aziri, Interstate Daydream. You got Frank Sarquette and the Birdie. And you got More Than Eddie and the Double.
In the Double. More like no, it. More Than Ready Eddie.
More Than Ready
Eddo, Eddie. Punch out, Eddo.
All right. Well, that's it. Episode 2 in the books. You heard it first here.
You're not going to give us an Aziri pick? Give me an Aziri pick.
Oh, okay. You want an Aziri pick.
It isn't going to be a lot.
Secret Oath, Clairiere, Interstate Daydream.
Give me one.
I got to go Clairiere. I got to go Asmussen. I love it. I love Clairiere.
It's hard. It's a hard race.
It's a hard race because you know what? Off of a layoff on the dirt.
At Oaklawn.
I mean, Lovely Ride could go gate to wire. Nobody has her. Unfortunately.
She's just not as good as these.
No, she's not. I like Clairiere coming off the break after that big effort in the Breeders' Cup Fillies. Yeah. I like Clairiere.
My degenerate ass will probably play a double with
all three. You know why I don't like Secret Oath? You got to guess why I don't like Secret Oath.
Huh.
Yeah, just give it, like, I'll give you.
Dwayne Lucas.
Correct. I just don't trust Dwayne Lucas like that.
But when he wins, you're like, Dwayne Lucas.
Yeah, you know, he always freaks with these 3-year-olds, but I haven't seen him be consistent with a really good grade one.
Because there is no consistent.
Right.
Bro, he races them 100 times a year, and they win randomly. But Secret Oath
is a beast. Secret Oath is a beast.
If Secret Oath wins, are you going to be shocked?
No.
Absolutely
not. I won't be shocked.
So my degenerate self, I'm not saying it now because I haven't even
looked. No, you got Interstate Daydream, though.
So
it don't matter.
But I will play a double. I will play a double or a pick 3 or something that involves all of them.
He will play a double that might lose money, might win a
lot. Not have Clairiere. That'll just have Clairiere. Secret Oath and Interstate
Daydream. Yeah.
I think Clairiere needs one. I think Clairiere is on the way out.
Wow.
Bye bye, Clairiere. Bye bye, Brad.
That's my girl.
She's good. She was.
She is.
Some good racing this weekend, you guys. And that's it, you guys. The Before the Odds podcast is done. We're out for today. We did Tampa. We did a little bit of Oaklawn. We did a little bit of Gulfstream. We hit the stakes races. You got Pick 5 Johnny. You got Big Willis.
West Side.
We really enjoy this, man. We really do. I forgot about Santa Anita. West Side Killer. But it's because I like to let Santa Anita get out of my mind. But we really enjoy this. And you guys, please like and subscribe. We're trying to push this. We're trying to open up horse racing to new minds, new people. And who other better than some young studs, right? Johnny?
Easy money.
But no, we really do like this, and we appreciate everything you guys do. So like and comment, and we appreciate it. We're out.